get him. It's a red stick.
Welcome back to Doesn't Pay Full Price. I'm Jim, and today we are talking about oysters. I've got some East Coast, I've got some West Coast. I'm gonna show you how to shuck them at home. I also have some classic traditional raw preparations, as well as a little nod to New Orleans with some char-grilled oysters. You're gonna wanna stick around, trust me. First things first, if you're getting oysters, especially to eat raw, you're gonna wanna get them from a reputable source. This is not the time to get them from the guy selling them out of a cooler on the side of the road, and maybe skip the Safeway or Save A Lot fish counter. Whole Foods are above, a place that's gonna go through a lot of volume, or a market that specializes in seafood that's not gonna have oysters sitting around for 1 to 2 weeks. Got it? I went to Whole Foods and just got a bunch of different oysters. Up at the top here, I've got the East Coast oysters. There's Rochambeau as well as Wellfleet's. Then down at the bottom, we have our Pacific Coast oysters. I got Kushi as well as Kumamoto. An oyster is an oyster, right? Why get a bunch of different kinds? What's the difference between East Coast and West Coast? Well, they're gonna taste different depending on where they're from. Oysters from the East Coast are gonna be a little saltier, a little brinier, just like the people out there. It's fine, I can say it, I'm from Massachusetts. It's very true. Oysters from the Pacific are gonna be a little less salty, a little smaller, and a little sweeter. Also kind of like the people. I guess except for the sweeter part. If you're going to a market that carries a wide variety of different oysters, I say get two or three of each type and see what you like best. When it comes time for shucking, you're gonna need a couple tools to help you out. First of which being an oyster knife. You could also use a butter knife or a flathead screwdriver in a pinch. And you're also gonna need a kitchen towel or a safety glove, whichever you have on hand. Just make sure to fold the kitchen towel over a couple times. That's what's gonna protect your hand from the knife. Then every oyster has a flat side and a curved side. You're gonna wanna make sure to place the cupped curved bottom on the towel with the hinge facing out, and then using your oyster knife, push and twist at the same time into the hinge until you feel it just pop right through and you've broken that hinge. Then, before you go any further, make sure to wipe off the knife. You don't want to get any of that shell into the oyster. Then hold the knife the long way and just slide it down the length of the shell, removing the top. Then just separate the oyster from the muscle and you have a perfectly shucked oyster. A lot of the recipes I looked up for char-grilled oysters varied pretty widely, but I've got everything here that you're gonna need to make really solid char-grilled oysters. I'm gonna put all the quantities in the description below, so depending on how many oysters you're making, this might vary just a little bit. We're gonna start by chopping up a couple cloves of garlic, some green onion, and some Italiano parsley. Then get yourself some good quality unsalted butter, break out your favorite saucepan, and put that over medium-low heat, and we're gonna start melting that butter. Once your butter's nice and melty, turn the heat down to low and throw in your garlic and green onions. Give this a stir for a couple minutes. You don't wanna brown this, you just wanna cook it really light just to release some of those aromas. Add in just a few dashes of Worcestershire sauce. Next, we're gonna squeeze in a little bit of lemon. It's okay if the seeds fall in, just fish them out with a little fork. There you go, I think that was all of them. A lot of the recipes I looked up called for chili flakes, but I've got a little secret up my sleeve. Instead of that, I'm gonna use some hot oil that you can get from the Asian market or Trader Joe's. It's basically chili flakes with crispy onions and garlic already in it. So I'm gonna add just a tad bit of this.
Give a little stir and take it off the heat so we can make our Parmesan crust. So in a little bowl, combine your Italiano parsley along with a little bit of lemon zest, and then get yourself a nice block of Parmesan cheese and grate it very liberally. You cannot have too much of this. Then just give it a little stir, make sure it's all combined. And that is your herbed Parmesan topping.
I was gonna charbroil these oysters out on the grill. However, it is dumping snow right now. So we're gonna do it inside. I've got the broiler preheated as hot as it'll go, 500 degrees. I've got the oysters set on a baking rack on a sheet pan. I'm gonna top each oyster with about a tablespoon of our garlic butter mixture. Top it with just a sprinkling of our Parmesan cheese. Some people wait and do this at the end. I like the cheese to get nice and crispy. So I'm gonna do it now. Put it under the broiler for about 10 minutes until the edges of the oyster start to get ruffled and all the cheese is nice and caramelized and delicious. Then take it out, I'm gonna drizzle just a little bit more of our garlic butter on right at the end, and enjoy. We've got char-grilled oysters, now we just need something for the raw oysters, which you could go classic and just do some horseradish, maybe a little bit of lemon, or you could finely dice up some green apple, mix it with a little bit of red wine vinegar, a little bit of champagne or Prosecco, a little bit of finely diced green onion or shallots. Finish it with just a sprinkle of salt, and you have a champagne green apple mignonette. However you prefer to enjoy them, here are a couple easy ways to have fantastic oysters at home. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Jim with Doesn't Pay Full Price. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Doesn't Pay Full Price. Hit that subscribe button, that like button on the way out, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.